Ramaya Ramabhadraya Ramachandraya Vedase Raghunathaya Nathaya Sitaya Pateye Namaha. Ayodhya Kant, Chapter Number 95, The River Mandakini. This is a continuation of the previous chapter. In Chapter Number 94, Lord Rama praised the beauty of Chitrakuta to Mother Sita. And in this chapter, he is praising the beauty of Mandakini River and its multicolored beaches and swans and geese and deer and flowery trees to Mother Sita. Verse 1. Ata shailad vinishkramya maithilim koshala ishvara adarshayat shubhajalam ramyam mandakinim nadim. They descended the hill and Rama, the ruler of Kosala, showed Sita, the daughter of King of Mithila, the holy stream Mandakini flowing with sweet, pellucid water. Verse 2. Abravit cha vara aroham charu chandra nibha ananam videha rajasya sutam ramo rajiva lochana. The lotus-eyed Rama spoke to Sita, the beloved daughter of King Janaka, who had an elegant waist and whose face resembled the full moon. Verse 3. Vichitra pulinam ramyam hamsa sarasa sevitam kusumer upasampannam pashya mandakinim nadim. My love, said he, see you yon Mandakini? How curiously fashioned those sandy hillocks are. Swans and other aquatic birds dart here and there among the lotuses in mad joy. There are a charming sight to see, even as your sweet self in all the beauty of your slender waist, swelling hips, tapering thighs, lovely hands and feet, adorned with melodious ornaments and fair face radiant with pleasure. Verse 4. Nana vidhai tira ruhair vrittam pushpa phala drumai rajantim raja rajasya nalinim iva sarvataha. Numerous trees line the banks heavy with flowers and fruits and put to shame the pools in which Kubera disports himself with his wives. Verse 5. Mṛga yūta nipātāni kaluṣa ambhāṁsi sāmpratam tīrthāni ramaniyāni ratim samjanayanti me. This water invites me to bathe in it. Troops of wild beasts drink at the spot and the turbid stream wears a garment of lovely red in consequence. Verse 6. Jata ajina dhara kale valkala uttara vasasa rishiyatu avagahante nadim mandakinim priye. O beloved Sita, behold yon ascetics that come to bathe at stated times in the sacred river in all the majesty of matted hair and deerskin robes. Verse 7. Adityam upatishtante niyamad urdhva bahva ete apare vishal akshi muniya samshita vrata. O lady of wide eyes, there stand others who pray to the Lord of Light with lifted hands and stern observances. Verse 8. Maruta udhuta shikarai pranrita iva parvataha padpai patra pushpani srijat bhir adbhuto nadim. The trees that crown the lofty peaks are tossed by strong gales and strew the waters far and wide with flowers and leaves like skillful dancers who toss their arms to and fro and scatter flowers around them. Verse 9. Kachin mani nikasha udam kachit pulina shalinim kachit siddha jana akirnam pashya mandakinim nadim. Here the water is clear as crystal. There small mounds of sand lift their heads above the surface. There the siddhas play in the cool waves in great glee. Verse 10. Nirdhutan vayuna pashya vitatan pushpa samchayan papluyamanan aparan pashya tvam jala madhyagan. O lady with a slender waist, does this not remind you of a doting husband clasping in passionate embrace the love of his heart, her fine dress of shimmering white more revealing than veiling the beauty of her tapering thighs, faultless in the symmetry? Clusters of flowers are driven ashore by the strong breeze in some places. In others, the bunches are happily borne along the current. It looks as if the lover had torn half a piece from the garment of his lady love. Verse 11. Tamcha ati valgu vachaso rathanga ahvayana dvija adhirohanti kalyani nishkujanta shubhagira. O auspicious lady, look at the chakravakas that sit thereon and melodiously invite their mates to play with them. Verse 12. Darshanam chitrakutasya mandakinya cha shobhane adhikam puravasa cha manye cha tava darshanat. O lovely woman, is it not more delightful to make our home on Chitrakuta than in the crowded town of Ayodhya? A town life is nowhere by the side of this retired, quiet abode where we can enjoy ourselves undisturbed by others. I consider the site of Mandakini River and of Chitrakuta, particularly at your site, to be most enchanting. So once again, Rama praises the beauty of Chitrakuta and Mandakini, but he says that the beauty of Chitrakuta and Mandakini River are enhanced by the presence of Mother Sita. And Mother Sita is now not in Ayodhya, therefore Rama too prefers to be with Sita in Chitrakuta mountain near the Mandakini River. This shows a very deep affection that Rama has for Mother Sita. And another point is that we do know that Chitrakuta is a very holy place because that's where Bharata and Rama had a very loving reunion. And Rama himself says that this mountain is very wonderful. And we know that Ayodhya is a sacred dhamma. Similarly, Chitrakuta too is a very sacred place. Verse 13. Vidhuta kalushai siddhai tapodama shama anvitai nitya vikshobita jalam vihahasva mayasaha. Here come to bathe every day pure soul siddhas who engage themselves in severe tapasya with restrained senses and thoughts. This is an extremely sanctified spot thanks to their presence here. Come, let us bathe and swim in the cool waters of the Mandakini. Everything is ready towards it. Verse 14. Sakhi vachcha vigai hasva site mandakinim imam kamalani avamajanti pushkarani cha bhamini. O lovely Sita, put away fear and timidity from you and enjoy yourself with me as you would in the company of your playmates. The wavelets caused by the motion of your breasts and thighs will submerge the thick carpet of red and white lotuses that cover the waters. Verse 15. Tvam paura janavad vyalyan ayodhyam eva parvatam manyasva vanite nityam sarayuvad imam nadim. Transfer your affections and solicitous care from the people of Ayodhya to the poor beasts that dwell hereabouts. Take it that Chitrakuta is your Ayodhya and Mandakini your Sarayu. Verse 16. Lakshmana chaiva dharmatma
mannideshe vyavastitha tvam cha anukula vaidehi pritam janayatho mama.
The righteous Lakshmana respects my least wishes. You are a wife after my own heart. Both of you cause me great delight. Verse 17.
Upasprisham tri shavanam madhumula phala ashana na ayodhyaye na rajyaya sprihaye adya tvaya saha.
Bathing in the holy waters in the morning, midday and evening, honey, fruits and roots my only food, your sweet self my beloved companion in my roamings through the woods, I clean forget Ayodhya, and I do not desire for any kingdom. Verse 18.
Imam hi ramyam gajayuta lolitam nipita toyam gajasimha vanarai supushpitai pushpadharair alankritam naso asti yah syan nagata kramah sukhi.
The beasts of the forests wander in herds along the banks of the river Mandakini. Elephants, lions and monkeys put away from them their inborn hate and ferocity and drink at the same ford thanks to the yogic might of the Maharishis. Who would not forget all care and anxiety and rejoice as he wanders through the woods that line its banks, bending low under their tribute of flowers and fruits?
Verse 19. Iti iva ramo bahusangatam vacha priya sahaya saritam pratibhruvan chachara ramyam nayana anjana prabham sachitrakutam raguvamsha vardhana.
Thus did Rama describe to his beloved the beauties of Mandakini and roam with Sita in the dark forests that cover the sides of Chitrakuta mountain. So from chapter number 94 and 95, wherein Rama describes the Chitrakuta mountain and the Mandakini river, it is fairly evident that Rama is very happy in the forest in the company of Mother Sita and his beloved brother Lakshmana. He is not hankering after Ayodhya. He is completely satisfied living in Chitrakuta mountain. In this chapter, as we learned in the previous one, Rama addresses Sita with some very beautiful terms. Let us go through those. In verse 1, Mother Sita is known as Maithili, or the beloved daughter of the king of Mithila. In verse 2, Valmiki refers to her as Videha Rajasya Sutam, or the one who is the beloved daughter of the king of Videha. Valmiki also calls her as Vararoham, or the one with a beautiful waist, and Charuchandra Nibhananam, or the one whose face glows like the full moon. In verse 6, Rama calls Sita as Priye, or beloved. In verse 7, he calls her as Vishalakshi, or the one with wide eyes. In verse 10, he calls her as Tanu Madhyame, the lady with a slender waist. In verse 11, he calls her as Kalyani, or the one who is very auspicious. In verse 12, he calls her as Shobhani, a very lovely woman. In verse 14, he calls her as Bhamini and also Sita. So that is, oh lovely Sita. In verse 15, he calls her as Vanite, or beloved, his darling. In the 16th verse, he calls her as Vaidehi, oh beloved daughter of King Janaka. So from the chapters 94 and 95, it is fairly obvious that Rama sprinkles a lot of endearing terms when he addresses Mother Sita. And this shows their domestic life Rama is very affectionate towards Sita, and Sita is very affectionate towards Lord Rama as well. Mangalam Koshalendraya Mahaniya Gunapti Chakravarti Dhanurjaya Sarva Bhumaya Mangalam.